Ladies and gentlemen, the winners, the producers for Best Picture Argo, we have Grant Heslov, Ben Affleck, and George Clooney.
Thank you.
And we really are on a time constraint, so you're all going to be angry with me. But it's going to be like five questions. I'm going to start with 175 and then go to
an auction.
Bingo.
Auction. Going once.
Let's get Scott a microphone, please.
Let's get a mic to 192, please.
175.
No, not 192.
320, please.
We're giving him another chance.
Sold.
Ben, obviously, you put a lot of work into the film as you were making it, but then after it's taken on this life of its own in your story, it's been so tied to your personal journey. Did you think that was something that was going to come out of making this film, this sort of redemptive comeback story that's been part of the narrative here?
Grant, you take that question.
Yes.
I love short answers.
I was excited about making the movie. These guys had a script. I really liked it. I called them up, said, I got a take for it. You know, will you put me on the movie? And I wanted to do the movie, and I wanted to work with them. That's what I thought would happen. You know, I wanted to work on something quality. I did the movie. We all worked really hard. I hope that people would like it. I didn't take a more meta approach to it than that. I was excited to make it. I was excited to work with these guys, the cast we had, and I was willing to let the chips kind of fall where they may, as long as we thought we had done something that we were interested in.
We're going to 261, then over to 138.
Uh-oh. Hi, back here. Obviously, at certain points, we thought that other films might win this. Could you describe when exactly you felt a tipping point in your favor?
Michelle Obama.
Tonight.
Yes. When they gave us the trophies, I was confident that we would win. I did second guess. Is this a prank?
He did look at the envelope. Yeah.
Even when I was giving the speech, I didn't feel as though we'd won. So.
Once Grant let me talk, I felt good. I don't get into too much into the Oscarology and the pontificating and the guys who do that stuff and report on it, which is great, and people like it, and they're interested in it, and people should be. I hope people are interested in the Oscars because it helps our industry and it helps make better films, but it doesn't help me to read up on that stuff. So, you know, I was thrilled for Billy. I was thrilled for Chris. And, when it came along, I was thrilled for these two guys.
Yeah. And Ang Lee.
We're going to 138 and then number four.
Hello, I'm over here. I'm Donna Arist from the Foreign Service Journal, the American Foreign Service Association in Washington. Your movie and also the comments you've made on all of the award ceremonies has really raised the image and the profile of the Foreign Service, something that we don't get very often. We don't get much play. But I would like to invite you, all three of you, to the plaque ceremony that we have in the Department of State on May 3rd, where we honor fallen Foreign Service officers this year.
I'm going to have to interrupt, but do you have a question?
Yes. Can you come?
That's a really personal question.
Volume or just...
I'm able to, yes.
There's a line.
I went too far.
Here's a line. There's
I don't know that we can come, but we do have, all of us, a tremendous respect for what the Foreign Service sacrifices and goes through, and that we, I think, gain further appreciation for that as we shot the movie, visited the State Department. I know Secretary Clinton a little bit and Secretary Kerry a little bit better, and so, you know, we were able to shoot but from my sort of distant acquaintanceship with both of those secretaries, I've really picked up an appreciation for what the State Department does, what our Foreign Service does, what they sacrifice.
We'll be in, Grant and I will be in Berlin shooting, so we won't make it, but maybe Ben might be in town.
Thanks, George.
We're going to come down here to 4 and then to 152.
Right over here. Tanya Hart, how are you? Congratulations.
Hi.
How cool was it to have the First Lady announce that you had just won an Oscar?
I was sort of hallucinating when that was happening. You know, and in the course of a hallucination, it doesn't... You know what I mean? It doesn't seem that odd when some other, look, a purple elephant. You know what I mean? Oh, Michelle Obama. It just seems like it's natural because the whole thing is so unnatural. No, I mean, honestly, I was just asking these two guys outside, like, was that Michelle Obama? I thought, the whole thing kind of overwhelmed me at the time, but in retrospect, you know, the fact that it was the First Lady was an enormous honor, and the fact that she clearly was surrounded herself by servicemen and women was, special, and I thought appropriate. I myself... Anyway, it was very cool.
It was really cool.
And I'm a big fan of the bangs, so.
We're going to 152 and then don't shoot the messenger. We got one more after that. Well, 66. So 152.
Congratulations, gentlemen. Charlie Reeves right over here to your right. Ben, throughout the award season, you've been very humble about what we feel, you know.
Yeah, forget that. No more humility. No more.
No, I can't. There's too many journalists.
No, but being left off the best director docket, and through that, how has that changed with all of the recognition that you've received, and where are you with that now?
I wasn't aware that you were left off.
You were left off?
I didn't get nominated as a director.
Really?
Grant, you didn't either.
I was nominated as an actor.
Is that right?
Not in the movie.
No shit.
No.
That's a crime, folks. I honestly, you know what? How I feel about that? Naturally, I was disappointed, and a lot of people said, "Oh, this is something that's going to happen." But when I look at the directors who were, you know, people who weren't nominated as well, I look at Paul Thomas Anderson or Catherine Bigelow, who's just amazing, you know, Tom Hooper and Quentin Tarantino, who you have spoken to or you will speak to. These are all directors who I admire enormously. So it was just a very tough year.
You were in good company not to be nominated.
Exactly. The five on the bench.
I'm actually glad you weren't nominated.
It was. You know what? You're not entitled to anything. I'm honored to be here. I'm honored to be among these extraordinary movies, and I'm really, really honored to win an Academy Award. So this is not a point where I'm spending a lot of time second guessing or worrying about anything.
And this is the last question. 66 in the back.
Yeah. Hi there, Ben. I'm just wondering over here.
I'll see you, Mike.
Thank you.
There he
is. Just wondering if you have any reflections at this point about making films about true life events. In your movie, you included a cameo of President Carter. You spoke at the start about Mossadegh and the politics that was involved there. Yet the film drew a little bit of flack for some of its treatments of New Zealanders and blending characters and the run down the runway at the end. Do you have any thoughts about how to approach these things now?
Sure. Well, let me just start by saying I love New Zealand and I love New Zealanders. Tempted to end there, as a matter of fact. But we did very well in Australia and New Zealand. I think that it's tricky. You walk a fine line. You're doing a historical movie, naturally you have to make some creative choices about how you're going to condense this into a three-act structure. It's not an easy thing to do. You try to honor the truth of the essence, the sort of basic truth of the story that you're telling. I'm really proud of the movie. I'm proud of the people that worked on the movie. The story that we're telling is true, and that we told is true. And it's not an easy thing, but it's, you know, I think constructed as well as it could possibly be, and it's a complete credit to Chris Terrio rather than me.
Congratulations, gentlemen. And
thank you. See you. Thank you. That way or this way?